So I've got some plain freeze-dried ground coffee here. So I'm just going to take a little bit of that. And what I'm going to do is to re-crush it so it's uneven. Some of it will be very powdery and some of it will keep its larger. Granules. The other coffee I'm going to use is freshly ground coffee, so it's still very well, it's fine, but it's not as fine as I want it, so I'm going to do a little bit more and really grind it up just an extra bit. So the other thing I want to be using is these lily stamens. So I'm just going to take them off their stalks. So now that I have all the stamens off, you'll notice that it's actually stained the ceramic and also my fingers. So be very careful with these. Probably best to wear gloves. If you're joining me on my channel, today I'm going to be using the Stratford medium coarse grain, 100% cotton watercolour paper. So as you can see here, I've done a little drawing, but I want to do something slightly different. So I'll grab myself some coffee. This is instant freeze dried. I've got myself some lily stamens and I have myself some freshly ground dark roast coffee beans. So my first job is to actually just wet the paper, and I'm going to go around the objects. Oops. So I'm not worried about the edges. I'll just go up to the as close as I can. And then I'm going to take some of my coffee, and I'm going to use a very large pair of tweezers for this next bit. So we all know that lily stamens stain, and you'd all be thinking it's all going to be yellow. Wait and watch. These give you some very interesting effects, and as they stain, they don't come off. Okay, so back with the water. I'm just going to spray some water over the top, and I'm going to leave that, and that will allow, you may actually need an hour for this to do its thing. In fact, I might actually put some more of the stamens on. They start to look like dead caterpillars once they've taken on some fluid. I'm just going to get a little squirt. and we're going to leave that all to do its thing. If you've never used lily stamens before, so this is water with a couple of lily stamens on, you'll be assuming that all of this would be yellow stained. Of course it isn't, it's got this purple blue stain from the actual, this is what's left from the actual stamen. Only the pollen gives you the yellow. This doesn't come off, so I couldn't go back and lift this, but it gives you some wonderful patterns and colour. You can probably start to see, I mean this is still very very wet, but you can start to see all the purpley blues coming out from those lily stamen. If you are going to try this at home, please make sure you keep all animals and children away from all the parts of the lily. These are extremely poisonous to your pets. So you can see here, I have the colours for my moth. Now, my moth actually hatched. You can see the spatula that she was actually sat on, so you can see how small she actually was. So I'm going to use this for my colours to be able to get this olive and pink colour in. So now that this is dry, I can actually get on and do some painting. So you'll find with the ground coffee beans, some of that is still there, but I quite like the texture there, so I'm trying to try and keep that there. This is instant coffee, freeze dried, so you get this lovely rusty old feeling with that. And of course it smells nice. You can also see, probably a little bit better sort of round here, everybody would have been expecting yellow to come off those stamens because they were lilies, but actually you've got this blue and purple mixes that have come off onto here. Now this doesn't come off, so this is going to be by undercoat. Okay, so I'm going to make a start with some burnt sienna. And this is French burnt sienna, so it's just a tad deeper in colour. And I'm going to come into the escarchion and the lock area. Just apply a little bit of water, not a lot. And again, I'm just going to drop some of this into the wet. So again, I'm continuing with the idea of it being very worn, rusty. So now that I've dropped that in, I'm just going to drop in a little bit of sepia. And again, because of the water, it's going to dilute just a tad. Okay, so I'm going to start with some of my darker areas. So this is, again, it's just sepia. And fill in that dark While everything else around the lock is actually drying, I'm going to make up some black gouache. Now, I really like this stuff. It's liquid form, and you might be able to see this or not, but it's actually stained my brush, so it tells you how deep it's going to be. So I'm going to go back and fill my lock with this extra black so that this really does recede. And as with all gouache, it should settle to a very flat finish. Obviously being matte, it should look like a deep hole. There's a little bit of bronze that I've made up just to go in a few of the areas. Okay, so I've almost finished the lock, so I'm just going to use a pencil to just find the edge of the door. So again, I'm just using the grain to help me. So I've mixed up some white gouache. I'm just going to use my rigger and put these antennae in. So you can see here I'm testing all my colours, just to see if I can get close enough to the colours of this moth. So remember, it's an elephant hawk moth, which is a bit olive green and magenta coloured. So I've been playing around with some opaque gouache and some watercolour. So I'm going to start with my magenta and just get this upper edge in. Remember, all the colours underneath are staining, so I'm not going to be able to remove any of these. So right now I'm just concentrating on the markings. And as they are fur, I'm just trying to keep small little brush strokes so that they look like fur. Okay, I've just swapped to Opera Rose, which I'm just going to lay over the top of the magenta. So that should give us nice contrast. And then I'm going to put some extra hairs with the Opera Rose. So I have the dark and the light in the pinks. Okay, so I've just added a little bit of white to my mix and I'm just going to start getting these markings in. And now for the green. So I'm still using very small brush strokes. I want this to really feel like fur and fluffy. So I want to keep my brush strokes really short. They get too long and I'll end up with a lot more holes than I really need. So again, no pressure on the brush. It's really easy to just get really carried away and do really big strokes, but it actually ruins the effect that you're trying to get by being too hasty. Okay, I'm going to let that dry and then lighten it. As the gouache dries relatively quickly, it means that I can get on with this slightly lighter layer. So again, just using the tip of my brush. Again, I'm going to just keep picking up white into the green just to make sure that I have got some of those lighter areas in. So I'm just filling in all the white gaps.
Again, I'm not going to get rid of all of the darker green either. I want some of that showing through. Takes a bit of time, but it does start to build up quite quickly. And then you can start putting the crossing hairs in that really bring your insect to life. Again, just remember little tiny strokes, as these are hairs that are so tiny. So I'm going to keep going until every little white speck is filled in with something. So I'm just going back with some yellow mixed with a bit of the original green, and I'm just going to again lighten some of the areas that I can see. Have some light shining through.
Okay, so I'm going to do some darks into the background behind this moth. So I've decided that they should have more blue. So I'm going to use Prussian blue. So as you can see, this can go really, really deep in colour, but I'm hoping this will make this pop a little bit. And I'm not going to get rid of all the texture I've put in, so I'm just going to work in between it. Wet the brush. And just allow the water to blend that in. Again, texture is really lending itself from the paper to get this background. So this is where we're at so far, and you'll see that I've managed to cover where the handle should have been. So there's a lot of lily stamens on the handle, so I'm actually going to leave some of those. Okay, I'm just going to take a damp brush and a little bit more of that Prussian, and I'm going to use my brush on its side so it's picking up the grain of the paper. I'm just going to add a little bit of water around the edges here. And again, if necessary, I'll just go back over with a bit more grain. Okay, I'm going to keep this covered because, as you can see, I'm actually covered with the stain from the lily stamens, and it's also stained my brush. You might not be able to see this on camera, but this is the ferrule has actually been stained with the yellow. So I'm going to continue with the moth, and I'm just going to start with some opera now. I'm and put a base coat down. Okay, now a little bit drier, I'm going to go in with my limey green colour. I'm just going to cover this again so I don't get too stained. And just by tapping the brush, you can see I'm starting to get really hairy marks. I've just got to get them in the right direction. This only works with a really good point on a brush. Do the same down the back of the body. It's a slightly different approach to the one I used up there, because these are in different aspects. Again, I'll put some in the wing. Okay, here goes for our second layer. So again, I'm going to start with the wings and just smooth some of this out. Remember, this is the underside of the wing, so it's different to the other one. Get these edges in. I'll trim down some of the lines. I'm just going to put some darker in. And again, this may not be dark enough just yet, but I can always adjust later on. Just remember to cover this because it stains. I'm just going to go back and try and get some of those white areas filled in with some colour. I'm actually going to use this for the eye colour as well. Okay, I'm going to leave that to dry and go back to my pinks. So, quinacridone magenta. I do find this a really useful colour for doing anything nature-wise. I'm going to roll my brush back to a point. This has got a really good point on it, this brush, why I use it quite so often. And then I can start applying hairs again. Okay, I'm going to go back to the Opera Rose. See if I can get that really strong. Okay, I think that's dry enough for me to go back in. And again, I just want to keep this all covered because we know how much it stains. And then I'll just end up transferring that to somewhere else in the picture, which I don't really want. So I'm just going to put a little bit darker space here. Okay, I'm going to go back to the body. I think we've pretty much dry there. So again, I can go back with some of my mixes. Okay, so I'm going to use a 9B pencil and I'm going to start just using the tip and following some of the linear lines that are on the paper. I'm just going to make some more wood marks. Not being very precise about this, as you can see. I'm just going to use this on the side, and you can see again it will pick up the paper underneath. Really helpful. And then I can just literally pick out just a few extra lines. And again, I'm still trying to keep my hand off the paper because it's still going to stain my hands. Actually, some of this is still a bit damp, but I see I've just gone over his head. And I think I will call that done.